Zain bhai, please share your desktop. We can get started.
Shiv bhai, are you recording the video? No.
No. I have not started yet. Let first him share. So please, your presentation. What you are going to present?
In my organization. So prior to this, I was. I used to give the sessions and trainings within the organization. It was limited to the people whom I know. But I think this will be a wonderful platform for the people who want to benefit and understand how corporate culture works and what are things that you have to keep in mind when you are looking for a career as a fresh graduate. Okay. But before I start, Shoaib, can you confirm if you can hear me clearly or you want
to? Yes. Everything is perfect, actually. We can hear and we can see your side also.
Okay, gotcha. Fine. So let me see how many people we have on the invite so that I can talk accordingly. Shoaib, can you confirm how many we have online now?
As of now, I see there are 9 participants are there.
Okay.
So looks like more people will be joining. But Zain bhai, we have just put everyone on mute. So probably at the end, we'll unmute them and they can ask the question with on chat with you during the webinar.
Yep, gotcha. I think that sounds good. So hi, everyone. My name is Zain and I come with an experience of 14 years in corporate culture. I started my career with Bank of America, worked there for some time, then moved to Wells Fargo, currently part of Wells Fargo. And I think last December, I completed a decade with them, 10 years within the same organization. I know you will be asking a question to yourself, how come a person stay in a same organization for 10 years? And I think if I talk about my story, you can easily relate. If you want to start a career in corporate, okay, what is the best field that you have to select? Okay, and why it is important for any graduate or any person who's looking for a corporate job that they should go and find out what are their interests, what kind of stream that they are looking for, and why do you think that, you know, they will join that stream. So in today's session, I will go and talk about why career guidance is important and why everyone who is applying for a job, okay, who's basically out of the college has to do one exercise and what that exercise will help them. Okay, like Shoaib mentioned, if you have any questions, please park your questions. We'll take at the end of the session. However, if you feel like, you know, you need a personal guidance, please reach out to Shoaib and he should be able to help you out. Okay. Now coming to the next page, when I want to talk about the objective of the session, I know we have 1 hour to cover everything that we, sorry, my apologies. Yeah, I know we have got 1 hour to cover everything that we have for this session. I'll do my best to ensure that I'll cover the part and leave 15 minutes for you people so that you can ask me questions if you have any. However, if you feel like you have any questions in the mid of any of the slides, you can still send that question on the chat. I will look into those questions when once I complete talking. Okay. So now I know the people on the call today, you people will be spending 1 hour on this session. And let me tell you what you will get after 1 hour. After this session, okay, you will be able to understand 2 important things in your resume. The first thing is, what is your long-term goal? And second very important thing is, what are your strengths? I am sure you must have prepared your resume. And when you prepare the resume, what you will do is you will tend to take resume from someone else, okay? Or you will go ahead and take the resume from the internet. And guys, believe me, okay, it's no shame to admit that, you know, I also did the same mistake back in 2007 when I was starting my career with Bank of America. I also took some resume which I found in internet, and then I put up my credentials, change whatever I can, and then put up for the interview. Luckily, back that time, okay, we don't have this kind of competition, and I got through. Fine. But now if you go and see, your resume plays a very important role. Your resume can tell you if you can get an interview invite or not. Your resume pointers will help you to will help the interviewer to analyze if you are suitable for this position or not. Because every position that you see required a different skill sets. And by reading your resume, the interviewer will try to find out, do you have that skill sets or not? Once they see that, yes, the skill set is on the resume, then they will go and interview you. However, on the face, if you say, no, I don't have that kind of skill sets, obviously you never get a call for the interview invite. Okay. And I'm sure there are so many people who have seen, like, you know, who always have this issue. Hey, I always apply for so many jobs, but I never get interview call. Okay. The reason is check your resume. Okay. So in today's session, we'll talk about how do you define your long-term goal and what are your strengths? Okay. And the reason as to why I'm putting a stress on strength is I have conducted more than 200 interviews and I have given offer letter to more than 60 or 70 people within campus. So when I do interview, I have my personal experience and I make sure that, you know, I completely go with resume. The moment I realize that anyone has copied strengths or anything from someone else, yeah, could be a situation wherein, you know, you share a common strength with someone else. For instance, let's say, okay, I am good at communication. That is one of my strengths. That strength can be someone else's as well. Okay, however, everyone is not good at communication. Fine. So what I do is whenever I go for any of the interview, the first thing that I do is I look the resume. I go ahead and look into the strengths and I also go ahead and see what are the achievements that this person have. My question is not related to knowledge. My question is not related to domain. But my first question to the person is, okay, you have mentioned in your resume that, you know, you are very good at multitasking. And to let you know what is multitasking, multitasking is also a strength. Fine. And I will ask them, can you please explain why do you call yourself as a multitasker? Okay. And if the person fumbles, okay, I know if somebody has, done a homework and wanted to go for an interview, they are bang on. Okay. They will go ahead and give the answer for that one. However, if someone who has copied, who has taken the abstract from internet, then believe me, they'll not be able to answer. And I think that's something which will help us to decide, should we hire this person or should we just leave this person? Okay. So net, what I'm trying to say is after this session, when you prepare your resume, I want you people to go and see what are your strengths. Okay. Do you possess those strengths or not? Are those your actual strengths or not? Okay. Someone can ask me a question. Okay. You're talking about strength. Okay. But how do I find out, you know, what is my strength? Because so far I never worked with any of the organization. So far I never had any work experience. How can I go ahead and define my strengths? Okay. So everyone, irrespective of whatever culture that you are, maybe you are in, you are a student, you are in a college, maybe you are just looking for a job. For everything, you have some strength and you use it. And we always have to ensure that, you know, I use my strength to move ahead and I use my strength to sell myself. Okay. So this session is all about trying to find out, okay, what is my interest and how do I make sure that, you know, I use that interest and explore the opportunities and crack the interviews, okay? And by the end of the session, I'll also try to share what streams that you can look basis on your interest, okay? Now, before I go ahead, I wanted to share some experience of mine and one of my friend, and I think this can help you people out. As to why this activity is very important. Okay. Before I move ahead, I just wanted to ask the audience. Okay, you can ping me in the chat or reply if you know this or not. Have anyone performed an activity to know yourself? This is also called a strength finder. Okay, my simple question to you people is, okay, did anyone took a strength finder analysis test? It's a free of cost test that you see on internet. Okay, if you haven't taken, I strongly recommend go ahead and take this assessment post the session. That will help you out. Okay, so I wanted to share my story to make sure that, you know, you people get some inspiration from that and also one of my friend's story. So when I started working, to be very honest, I was not interested to join a corporate culture. I wanted to join education field or a coaching field because that was my interest. I used to love that forte a lot. And to keep you people informed, my elder brother, he's working as HOD in Shadan College and he's the head of a mechanical department. So since he was my inspiration, I also thought that, you know, I can also become a coach, a teacher or a professor. But then since I got this opportunity in Bank of America, I thought, let's give it a try. Okay. And I always have in my mind that I will just work for 1 week and then leave. Okay. I just wanted to experience how corporate culture works. And believe me, I come from a family, okay, who's very orthodox, okay. I mean, you people won't believe, we still don't have television at my home, okay. So we come from that family, and you know, suddenly changing from a student to a corporate culture, that was a new experience for me, okay. New people, new environment, everything was new for me. And to be very honest, I did not like the culture first. I was adamant that, you know, I don't want to join corporate culture. But I was just going because, you know, I just wanted to test for some more days. And once I complete my training, once I was put upon the production, believe me, I started enjoying it. And when I enjoyed, we had three sites at the time, Hyderabad, Gurgaon, and we had two sites at that point in time, Hyderabad and Gurgaon. So out of these two sites, we have 106 people who were part of same process. And believe me, 11 months in a consecutive time, I was a top performer out of 106 people. I was shocked, okay, that, you know, I also have this power. I also have this skill that, you know, I can go ahead and give my best when it comes to accuracy. Fine, so this is something that I realized when I was working as a associate. But then that excitement was not for a long time. I, after a period of 2 years, I thought that, you know, hey, this is usual for me. I don't want to do the same job again. Okay, I am looking for something else. I was ready for new challenges. And I think then I have taken a very risky decision to leave Bank of America and started searching for another job. And believe me, at the time, I had no other job on my hand. But still, I took a risk and did this. Now, I'll just take a pause here. And I want you people to correlate the same situation, maybe with your friends, maybe with yourself, if you have already experienced this kind of situation, and see what's wrong here. What is that thing which I missed and started my career? So if you see, I was not aware of my strengths. I was not aware of my strengths. I don't know what is my long-term goal. I don't even know what competences that I have, okay, but I just went with the flow and started my career, okay? Now, I'll give one more example. I have one of my friend, okay, he also did MBA along with me, and we started the career at the same time, okay, but not with the same organization, with different organization. I don't want to put that organization name here because I want to keep some things confidential. So he is very good. I mean, we had the same numbers when it comes to the end reports that we have during MBA. And he started his career with another organization. And believe me, after 1 year, he quit the organization. And he said, I don't want to work with MNCs, but I want to start my own business. Right. So this is the second example, what I'm trying to portray here. But in what I'm saying is, if you just want to begin your career without thinking anything, without thinking a long-term goal and all, believe me, you will end up. And why it is important for me as a person to go and find out my strength finder. Now, I'll put a little stress here why it is important, okay? I'm sure you must have seen that there's one very important challenge that everyone sees, okay? If you're a fresh graduate also, you will see this. Let's say if you have completed your graduation in 2020, you're still searching for a job, 2021 passed, 2022, you got interview invite, okay? The first question that you see is, okay, I see that you have a gap, okay? And they will ask so many questions on that career gap. They just wanted to understand why you had a gap, okay? The first impression that the interviewer will have the moment they see career gap is, okay, maybe this person did not put a lot of efforts to get into the organization. Maybe this person was doing something else which was not related to the career planning and all. So now, coming back to my question, okay, why it is very important for me to do a strength finder exercise is, if I do this at my early stage of career, believe me, I'll have a strong career. And at the end of 6th or 7th year, I will be a manager. By the end of 9th year, I will be a senior manager. By the end of 11th year, I will be an AVP or VP. Okay, now when this will happen? When you have a proper planning. Believe me, today or tomorrow, you'll get the opportunity. Today or tomorrow, you'll get some other job. But the question is, will you survive or not? Will you sustain that job or not? That is the biggest question that we should ask. And let me tell you, I can give one more example. I think there was one team member who was reporting to me. Okay, he was very normal. I mean, you know, in terms of providing accuracy in metrics, he was average. Okay, I never saw him, you know, giving more accuracy or going for some other targets and all, okay? He just used to come, okay, do his usual work, and then he used to leave. And then this one day when we had a one-on-one conversation, I asked him, okay, I see that, you know, you don't show interest. And I see that you just come, do you work and then you go, okay? I wanted to check, okay, what is the long-term goal? And at that point in time, this guy told me that, you know, he is very much interested to join a cricket team. And right now he's playing for a Ranji team from Chennai. Okay. So at that point in time, I asked him, I think you're wasting your time. Because the initial stages that you see in your career, okay, let's say you complete your graduation by 22nd of your year, okay, from 22nd till 28th, it's very important year, okay, this year can make your career, can break your career, can put you in depression, okay, so that's why it's always important for us to take a right decision. I know after this session, okay, someone can ask me a question, hey, I am actually just looking for a job to get started and, you know, earn bread and butter. That's also a very good question. But in the same time, okay, you should continue to hunt for your long-term career aspirations. Okay. So today in this session, we'll talk about how do you explore yourself? How do I know that, you know, what I'm good at? Okay. And then how do you determine your values? Okay. I'll give an example here. Like there are few values everyone gets. Okay. I am sure if you are coming from one community, okay, you never work for. Do we have any question? Okay. I think somebody's on mute. May I request them to put on mute? Gotcha. The second point that you see on the screen, determining values. Okay, this is something which is very important. Okay, now why it is important for me to understand my values? Okay. When I completed my graduation, the first job that I got was with Bharti AXA. How many of you know Bharti AXA? It's an insurance company, okay? But I did not attend the invite because that is something which is against my value, okay? So it is also important for you to understand what values that you carry, okay? And then you have to define what goals that you have, okay? Now, for you, money is important, career is important, or you're looking for something else, okay? That you have to define. And after this, okay, once you have the answer for these three things, okay, that you see on the screen, okay, then you should explore the world. Now, people can ask me, okay, I have all those three things, okay, but I'm looking for opportunity, I'm not getting it. Or let's say, okay, when you go for, when you go to buy new clothes, okay, obviously you try and then you buy it, okay. The same can happen with MNC as well, okay. Now, let me tell you, how can you try if any of the job is good for you or not, okay. Simple thing is internship. How many of you heard about internship? Right now, we have openings for internship and also for MR. MR is called as major resources. Okay, so what this activity will help is, okay, this activity will help you to understand the corporate environment, to understand if this is your cup of tea or not, and to make a valuable decision or informed decision, should I move ahead with this career or should I go to something else? Okay, and once you start exploring the world, okay, you have to ensure that you give the efficiency in that field, okay? It's very important to showcase yourself in the beginning of the years. I'm not saying that, you know, you have to leave once you complete 10 or 12 years, okay? But I hope you must have heard this phrase, okay? First impression is the best impression, okay? So any job that you attend, okay, you have to give your best, okay? Because the best start will always give you the bestest career. And after this, okay, you also have to ensure that, you know, you build relationship. There's only one thing which can get you jobs. There's only one thing that can help you portray yourself, which is something called as connects. Okay, I'm not sure if you people are on the LinkedIn. LinkedIn is the best platform. Again, guys, I'm not trying to sell LinkedIn here. I'm just trying to tell you this is one of the best platform wherein you can go and see. You can go and connect with the different people. I am sure when I used to look for job opportunities back in 2007 and 2010, we never had something called as LinkedIn, okay? And if I want to go and search the jobs, okay, what I have to do is I have to personally go to different consultancies and wanted to see, hey, do you have any job for me? Okay, this is my resume. But now I think everything is online, okay? You just have to put up your resume, okay? You just have to send the connects to different managers. For instance, if you're interested in Google, okay, find someone from Google HR, okay, send the connect, and I'm sure they'll accept your connect, okay? Drop them a message, hey, this is my you know, interest, and I'm looking for opportunity in your organization. Please do let me know whenever you have it, okay? They never might. Musab,
hey, oi, Farin.
I'm sorry, guys. So they never mind accepting your invite, and they never mind accepting your invite and, you know, providing you the opportunities that they have. Okay. And the last one is accepting responsibility for the future. So here you will. Okay. So here you will see that, you know, whatever responsibility that you get, you have to ensure that you handle it and you give the time to your responsibility as well. Okay. Because there is something which is called as work-life balance, wherein we know how do I draw a line between my personalized life and the corporate life. Okay. So I'll just take a pause here to see if you have any questions. I know we did say that the questions will be entertained at the end of the session, but I just wanted to see if you have any in the chat. Or Shoaib, did you receive any questions in the chat? Nope, I don't see anything. Okay.
Yeah, please feel free to ask the question on the chat. Have a discussion.
Right, gotcha. Nothing.
I see there are some questions actually. It was prior to this session. Okay, fine.
Right, gotcha. No worries, Shoaib. Okay, I'll continue and then maybe we can take questions at the end of the session. Okay. Now moving to next thing. Okay, what is why career counseling is important? Okay, I think we had a long discussion on this, why it is important and what will happen if you don't do this activity for yourself. It's simple. Okay, you may not be able to continue for a long time and you will waste those precious years which you can never get it back. Okay, and if you want to go and see guys, okay, if you want to go and see anyone who's at the bigger level, okay, see when they have started their career and all this information you can find on LinkedIn. Okay, let's say if I'm trying to follow Bill Gates, I'm just giving an example. Okay, I can go and check, okay, when did he start his career? Okay, what are the durations that he got the role change? Okay, so you will notice one important thing that, you know, these people have started very early. Okay, and these people have started early and they never have something which is called as job hopping. Okay, so job hopping is something wherein, you know, I work with one organization for 1 year, then I switch. Okay, why? Because I'm just looking for money. I think that is not something which you people should decide. Okay, so the first thing that you will that you should do is you should know yourself. Okay, what are your strengths? Okay, what are your areas of interest? We'll talk about this in the next slide. And career counseling will also help you to understand yourself. Okay, I can give you one simple example here. I think everybody is aware of cricket. Okay, how does cricket help? Cricket game works and all. Okay, and everybody knows Sachin Tendulkar. Okay, he is a very good batsman. Okay, now if we go and tell Sachin Tendulkar to bowl, okay, to do a bowling, do you think he's a great player there? He is not, because that's not his forte. Okay, the same way, if I go and ask someone else, like Mohammad Siraj is there. Okay, if I ask Siraj, okay, can you please do the batting? Okay, he may not be best at batting because that's not his forte. The same way, every person in this world have got a unique strength and you have to find out that unique strength. Okay, and I think one of the important activity which you can do apart from taking strength finder is, okay, you can always go back and ask feedback. Okay, you have your professor, you have your career counselors. Okay, I think CGC is the best platform. You can ask them, like, you know, hey, we have interacted so much. Okay, can you tell me good things about me? Okay, what I'm good at and all. Okay, and then the last thing is, okay, to define your long-term goal as well. I know most of the people, when you go for an interview, okay, one of the common question that you say is, hey, what's your long-term goal? And the reason as to why we ask this question is, okay, we want to understand, do you have a career aspiration or how serious are you when it comes to this job? Most of the people, they just come and say, hey, I want to see myself as a manager in next 5 years. I want to see myself as a senior manager in next 5 years. That is not the case. We are not looking for that answer. Okay. What we're trying to look is, okay, what you will do, what a value that you will add to the organization and what value that you add to yourself. So this is something that you have to provide the responses. And I think after this session, guys, go and take the interviews and believe me, you will see a difference in yourself. Okay, now the next biggest question that we have is, how do I know about myself? Okay, I know we've been talking about this, like, you know, I am not sure what are my strengths. Okay, what things that I can do better and all. I think I already spoke about internship. If you feel like you want to do experience anything like internship and all, okay, please let me know. Okay, we can give you some information on internship as well, and that can help you experience or try the corporate stream. Now, when you want to know yourself, what we have to do is, okay, this is a simple questionnaire that you see on the screen, and I want everyone to go back and write down the answers for this. Okay, this is very important, guys. Okay, I know sometimes you will see that, you know, hey, this is just like in some another session. Okay, but if you want to, if you're serious and if you want to do something for your career, I want you to write down the answers for this. The first question is, what do you like doing? Okay, what activities or tasks I don't like? Okay, I can give my example and I can tell you, when I started my career, the first thing that I like is, okay, I love to, you know, do my job. I was not interested in talking to anyone. I think weakness that I had back in 2007 is I never used to talk to anyone, because since I told you that, you know, I'm from an Orthodox family. Okay. When I joined Bank of America, I think I used to do my job very good, but I never used to interact with the people. And I always used to get a feedback that, you know, hey, you are not talking to anyone. Okay. You're not interacting with anyone. You have very less connects and all. Okay. But that's fine. Okay. Does that mean that, you know, I am not made for the corporate culture? It's not the case. Okay. The only thing is, you should know what are your strengths and you should sail through your strength. Okay. Second question is, what are my interests? Okay. What things that I like most? Okay. Now, when I say what are my interests, don't say that, you know, I like eating biryani, I like eating desserts and all. Okay. Those are your personal interests. Okay. What we're trying to get from this question is, when I say what are your interests, okay, I want you to tell me, okay, what things that you like when you work, okay, or let's say when you're doing a project in your organization. I'm sure if you were doing MBA, okay, you would have done a project, okay, a real time project, okay. So there's something that you must have liked, okay, like gathering information or preparing a report or something that must have taken you a lot of time and you enjoy doing it. Okay, so that I want you to write here. What values are important to me? Like I have given you example, like, you know, I don't want to work for certain organization because that is something which is against my values. Okay, so I think this is very important, guys. If you want to make sure that, you know, you have the correct choice, then please determine the values as well. Okay, like there are few people, okay, who say night shift, I cannot do it. A night shift is not my forte. Okay. That's fine, absolutely fine. Okay, but can you get a job? Can you get a day job? Yes, you can. You just have to go and explore yourself. Okay, now this is an important question. What are my skills? Okay, what things that I can do? Okay, when I talk about skills, I think there are so many sessions that you must have completed with CGC wherein they talk about skills and traits. Okay, there's a thin line difference between skill and trait. Trait is something, okay, this quality is in you when you were born. Okay, trait is a born quality. Okay, for instance, if I'm a good public speaker, okay, could be that, you know, this is something which I got from my birth. Okay, there are few people who are very good at talking. Okay, could be that, you know, you got this trait from your birth. Okay, there are few things which is called as skills. So trait is something that you have acquired from your birth, okay, from your parents, and skills is something, okay, wherein you work hard and you try to get it. Okay, for instance, if you're looking for a job in technology, okay, you have to ensure that, you know, you go and learn different skill set. Okay, for instance, you have Python, you have Java, you have Oracle. Okay, you go ahead and take those skills. Okay. So here I want you to write down your skills. I am sure there are people who have completed graduation. They have also completed some certifications to add value to the resume. I want you to write that. And then, what are your strengths? Okay, what you're good at? Okay, for instance, are you a multitasker? Are you a quality giver? Are you a quick grasper? Okay. Are you very punctual on time? Okay. All these things are strengths. Okay. You have to write down your own strengths. Okay. So when you take this assessment online, okay, you will get a list of 12 strengths. Okay. And I want you to write down only five, the first five. Okay. Rest seven will change as per your job requirements. Okay. And the last question that you have to ask yourself is, okay, what am I good at? Okay. What things that I do good at? Okay, for instance, there are few people, okay, like take the example of my team in my current organization. Okay, I have different people who reports to me. Okay, there are few people who are very good at taking trainings. Okay, it's like you don't have to tell them. Okay, they go and give or deliver a fantastic training. And there are few people who are not good at training, but they're very good at handling transactions. Okay, you ask them, hey, I want you to process 10 transactions today. They do it 10 transactions with 100% accuracy. Okay, so you also need to find out, okay, and this is something that you can do it from your project, okay, the project that you have completed or any task that you have completed. Okay, for instance, I know I was doing an interview for one of the campus recruitment back in 2017, I guess. Yeah. So at the time we were hiring people for risk services. Okay. Risk is a different skill that you need to have. Okay. We cannot hire everyone into risk services. Okay. So when I was hiring this lady, okay, she was very good in terms of communication. She was very good in terms of what she had written in the resume, but she does not have the skills of risk. Okay. Now, even at this point in time, okay, I have hired that lady. Okay. And, you know, I have a calculative decision there as to why I have hired that lady. The reason was she have a go-get attitude. Okay. Very positive attitude. She was like, you give me any work, I'll learn quickly and I'll make sure that, you know, I give your existing team a challenge. And I think the moment she said this, she was on. Okay. I mean, you know, we said, yes, we're going to hire this girl. Okay. So you also have to ask that question. What am I good at? Okay. And believe me, guys, everyone in this world have got different quality. Okay. A unique quality, which you will never find in someone else. Okay. So this activity, you will do it post this session. And I want you people to take it seriously if you're looking for a serious career. And get in touch with Shoaib or CGC if you have any questions on this. Moving to next thing. Okay, so this is the exercise which I want you people to do it. The first thing is Strength Finder. So Strength Finder is a activity, okay, which is created by Gallup first. Okay, if you people know what is Gallup, it's one of the fantastic organization we have, who provide different reports, who provide different artifacts, and also skills exercise to the organizations. Okay, so they are the one who has created Strength Finder. So you can take Strength Finder free of cost on the internet. Okay, just type Strength Finder on Google and take free assessment. So when you take free assessment, it will you have to spend some 30 to 45 minutes. And guys, one request what I have here is, okay, when you do that, I want you people to read the question carefully, because that will give you your strengths at the end of the exercise. So if you're not sure about what a question that you are writing, okay, please stop and ask someone, okay? But I want you to drive your actual strengths, okay? And please do this exercise and keep this exercise for yourself. And I'll tell you why this exercise will help as well. Let's say tomorrow when you're going for an interview, okay, somebody asks you a question, hey, what are your strengths? Okay, you go and tell, I am very good at communication. I am very good at, you know, handling multitasking. Okay, the person can ask you, okay, if I am your interviewer, I'll for sure ask you, okay, why do you call yourself as a multitasker? Okay, if the person gives me a response, hey, you know, from my college, whatever project that I work with, I work on different multiple projects, and I make sure that, you know, all the projects are completed on time. And I have also taken a Strength Finder, and my top five strengths are so-and-so, so-and-so, so-and-so. And believe me, after this, you never see a follow-up question. It's like you are bang on, okay? You, the interviewer will move to the next question. And the next thing that you will see here is, okay, long-term goal. Okay, once you complete your Strength Finder, I want you to determine what's your long-term goal. Okay, for instance, there are few people who work on corporate culture for a temporary basis. Okay, that's absolutely fine. Okay, but still, I want you to define what's your long-term goal and short-term goal. Okay, for instance, okay, if you ask me what is my long-term goal, okay, I am looking to make, myself, okay, right now I stand at 13th year of my experience, okay, but even now I have a long-term goal. Okay, I am part of second line of defense right now. I deal with different banking regulations that we have with the United States, and what I'm planning to do in next 5 years is, okay, I want to ensure that, you know, I have skills of CIA, I have skills of first line, second line, and third line defense, and after 5th year from now, okay, I should be able to handle any review that I get within my team, okay, without anyone else's support. Okay, so this is my long-term goal. Now, after this, there's something which is called as interview questions. Okay, I am sure you are aware of mock interview questions, which is available on the internet. Okay, and this is again based on the competencies. Okay, if you feel that you got a strength as communication, I want you to go and take all the interview questions related to communication. Okay, and I want you to answer those questions. And once you do this, I want you to start searching for a job description and streamer apply for it. Now, I'll just take some time, okay, to tell you people, how should I decide what stream is good for me, or what organization that I should start with. For instance, let's say I have completed BCom, okay, and I have just completed BCom, okay, I haven't done MBA and all, okay, that's absolutely fine, okay. guys, I want to you know, clear this statement here. I know there are so many people out there who think that, you know, if I'm a graduate, I may not get the opportunity, and if I complete my MBA, I may get good opportunity. That's not the case. That's just a myth that we have. Okay, I have personally interviewed so many people. Okay, the group had graduates and also postgraduates. Okay, but believe me, do we see postgraduates and graduates? At least I don't see that. Okay, for me it doesn't matter. Okay, what matters is how you perform in the interview. Okay, and yes, I have seen so many people, okay, who are just graduate. Okay, they go ahead and crack the interview and then they will pursue MBA. Okay, they just don't want to give the burden to their parents. Okay, they want to ensure that, you know, they have bread and butter and they also have money for their next studies and all. And one thing which you will always see with the good people or the people who are doing successful in corporate culture is they never stop learning. They always learn. And if you want me to talk about myself, I am doing CIA now. Okay, so CIA is nothing but Certified Internal Auditor. So in the world, there's only 4% people clear this certification. I'm not talking about India. It's all over the world. Okay, but still I took that challenge. I want to do it. Okay, the same way when you complete these three exercises, strength finder, long-term goal, interview questions, I want you people to go ahead and target the organization. Now, very simple thing is, before you target the organization, I want you people to go ahead and make a LinkedIn, fantastic LinkedIn profile. I want you people to start making the connections. I want you people to send the connect request to all the HRs, to all the good managers, I mean, at the higher level, okay? For the connects, okay. Now, what will happen when you send the connect? Okay, the moment you send the connects, okay, your LinkedIn will feed you what's happening with that organization, okay, what they are doing right now, and you know what they are good at. Okay, for instance, when I was working with Bank of America, I used to deal with bank reconciliation statement, right? Okay, all the BCom people can correlate this term, okay, it's very easy. Okay, I know I have done BRS in my BCom, okay. But we also have people who are coming from BSc background to do that job. Okay. So what I'm trying to say is, whatever things that you have learned in your education, okay, not necessary that all of the things are applicable. You will not see even 2% of the things are applicable when you do the job. Right. So now what you have to do is, the first, after you complete these three exercises, okay, what you have to do is you have to create a fantastic LinkedIn profile. You have to send the connects. And once you send the connects, once you start listing down the organizations, for instance, let's say I have started sending connects and I know I have, I'm just giving an example, guys. Okay, this is not for, what do you say? You don't have to go and put me on the spot saying that, hey, you said Genpact and I want you to get the job in Genpact. Okay, so let's say I'm giving example of Genpact. You have Accenture, you have Dell, you have Google. Okay, all those things are there. Now, once you do this, I want you people to go and get the feed. Okay, follow them on LinkedIn. And once you follow them, okay, you will see all the jobs that they have. Okay, all the openings, what are the current happenings that they have. And then you can go ahead and apply for that one. Okay, now, when you apply using this way, let me tell you what will happen, what difference that you can make. Okay, the first thing is, anyone who asks you this question, okay, why should we hire you, or what do you know about the organization? I think you will be in a better position to answer what you have learned about the organization, and you can also tell the interviewer what were the current happening that happened with this organization. Okay, for instance, if you follow them on LinkedIn, okay, you will see what current happenings that they were having. Like, you know, sometimes you will see that any organization have spent so much of money on flood and all, and they have done a CSR activity, all those things. And believe me, guys, the more you know about the organization, you have a better chances of clearing the interview. It's like no one can stop you to get that job. Okay. So what I'm trying to say is, okay, you have to list down the organization which you're looking for. For instance, let's say I am a BCom graduate. Okay. I will go ahead and target all those jobs. Okay. Which does not require skills like Python, Java, and then other skills. Okay. Obviously, when you read the job description, you will understand. And also when you see the organization structure, you will understand what kind of opportunities that they have. Okay, for instance, if you want to go and apply for UBS, okay, UBS is something which is coming back again, guys, with a lot of opportunities. If anyone who's interested, please go ahead and apply. So they are coming back very strong, okay. And what kind of organization they are? Okay, they are someone, okay, who help the banking function. All right. So the moment you know that, you know, this organization help banking function, okay, you should know that, you know, whether this is my target organization or not, okay, or should I go ahead and search something else. For instance, let's say I am an engineering graduate. Okay, I don't understand the accounts and all. Okay, in that case, there are so many organizations who provide engineering things. Okay, for instance, if you want, I can also, I think there are so many openings which is provided by the CGC group itself. I mean, they share the openings related to different streams and different organizations. So the activity what I'm suggesting right now here is, okay, you should create a fantastic LinkedIn profile. Okay, you should know what kind of organization needs your skill set, and then start applying for the job. And let me tell you, when you do this activity, you will have better chances of cracking it. You will have better pay package, and you will never have a career gap. I think with this, I am done with my session. I know I spoke for about 45 minutes so far. And now I will take any questions that you may have. Okay, the questions can be related to anything, guys. Okay, not specific to this one, but any question that you have, please go ahead and ask, or I'll just give it to Shoaib to see what procedure that they follow when it comes to asking questions. Shoaib. Okay.
Gotcha. Shafiullah here, pardon me.
Yes, Shafiullah.
Thank you very much for the nice session. It's very much helpful for our newcomers. Thanks a lot.
You're welcome. I can see one question here. There's one question from Akhil. Okay, it says, my concern, I'm searching for a job in MSU. What will do, but I don't have, I have domestic process, but I want to go semi-voice process or non-voice process. I think this is one of the best example, guys. I know, Akhil, you must have worked for voice process, and then you are looking for something which is semi-voice process. To be very honest, if you're targeting for something which is a non-semi-voice process or non-voice process, the first thing that you have to do is you have to enhance your skills. Okay, for instance, I can go and refer you for different organization which can hire you based on your previous experience. But again, I think, Akhil, this is one of the best example that we have. Like, you know, when you started your career as a voice associate or a semi-voice associate, okay, with some calling process, you will continue to get opportunities within the same stream. However, if you want to change that stream, okay, what you have to do is you have to enhance your skills. Okay, you have to do something else to make sure that, you know, you target the other skill. Okay, to be very honest, Akhil, I never worked for a domestic process. I never worked for a voice process. Okay, so what I would suggest here is maybe you can share your resume, and like I told everyone, Akhil, okay, have your LinkedIn profile in a better way, and start searching, and then let me know if I can be of any help. But right now, to answer your question, what I would say is, if you're looking for a non-voice process, there are so many organizations which provides non-voice and a day job, okay? But they need a required set, okay? For instance, I know if you are coming from BCom background, but still you can learn something which is called as COBIT, okay? There's something which is called as Python, something which is called as ISO 31000 certification. So this certification costs very less, not more than 7,000 or 8,000. But the moment you add this certification in your resume, believe me, you'll start getting opportunities. And for the people who don't want to go outside and do certification, but they are looking for free of cost certification, I will just ping the name, application name. You can go and register yourself here, and you can take any certification from here. Okay, so Udemy application is something, okay, which will help you to take so many certification free of cost, and this certification is valid as well. Okay, and now I will go for the next question. I passed out my BTech in 2018. I'm a computer science engineer looking for a job for work from home. Please suggest me which domain is best for me. Okay, so I think, Sana, the kind of question that you have, this is completely relatable to our topic today. The first thing is, you will have a strong questions coming up your way when you go for interview with regards to your career gap. However, if you can substantiate as to why you took a career gap, okay, that's absolutely fine. Okay, there are people who have a career gap of 8 years, 9 years, but they still start. Okay, so if you're looking for a job that was specifically from work from home, then I think this is bit difficult, but what you can do is you can still try. Okay, for instance, right now, okay, at this point in time, everybody is working from home. Even I'm working from home. Okay, I have never been to office from the last 1 year. Okay, so but if you ask me, do we have work from home option forever or permanently for the people? I think we do have some from Amazon and some from Qualcomm, but I think we need to check, Sana. Okay, like I told you, we have to check and we have to go for those options. But one important thing that you will have to see here is you have to prepare a strong reason as to why you have a career gap of 2 years, 2 or 3 years. Okay, so yeah, again, to answer your question, thing is, okay, create your strong profile, LinkedIn profile, and then start connects. And then, yes, the people who, what they do is, okay, the kind of question that you have asked here, okay, on the LinkedIn, they'll go ahead and ask the same question. And believe me, if there are any organization who are looking for that kind of skill set, they'll quickly ping you and you'll have a ready job available with you. Okay. And the only thing is, how do we try? How do we connect? Okay. And right now, guys, okay, the old method of, you know, reaching out to consultancies and all is gone. Okay. Everything is online now. So, yeah, the better you have LinkedIn profile, the better chances that you have of getting more opportunities. And, yep, that's it. And then again, we have a question from Akhil Rahman. I think this is the same that we discussed right now. I'm not, okay, anonymous process or whatever. So I will be a fresh, I'm not. Okay, fine. Akhil, I can refer you to an internship and then to a permanent employee, okay? But again, that's completely based on your performance in the interview, okay? See, the best thing what we can do is we can just refer you. And I know that there are a few people who come back and say, hey, can you just directly take me into the organization? Believe me, guys, okay, I'm also working for that organization. So the best what I can do, Akhil, for you is I can refer you, which means I can get you an interview call. But then from there, how do you perform? How do you answer the question? That's completely on you. Okay, I can do that for you. I will I'll let Shoaib know, or the host of this CGC know, about the contract openings that we have right now. Okay, I have 16-month domestic Flipkart process in Kavi Magnum. Okay, gotcha. Yeah, to answer Sayed Shahid's question, like I told you, there are so many organizations who start internship. Okay, internship is something which is completely a trial-based job, wherein the organization will test you and you will test the organization. It's both the way. Okay, if you don't like the organization, you can end the contract. If organization does not like your performance, they can end the contract. So what you can do is, okay, there's so many interns who start, and there's so many organization guys, okay, who start, who actually hire freshers, okay. But then the problem is, okay, they pay you less. But again, whenever you get this kind of opportunity, please go for it, okay. When you start your career, okay, your pay should not be a concern, because you're trying to learn. And once you learn the skill, believe me, you can charge them fourth or fifth time than that, okay. And then next one. Okay, yep. I think Ishaq provided Akhil a LinkedIn contact. Thanks, Ishaq. Gotcha. I think those were the questions that we have. With this, I am done, host. So thank you so much, CGC, for this opportunity. And to be very honest, I always like helping people out. I used to provide this kind of session to the Golconda training center. Okay, they are the one who's actually enjoying the same like CGC. So thank you so much, CGC, again for the wonderful platform. And I'm sure with this 1 hour of session, you must have got some information, and I'm sure you must have got some confidence to face your next interview. And anytime if you feel you have questions, anytime you feel you need a guidance, please reach out to CGC. They should be able to help you out. So with that, I will wind up. But before wind up, I'll just take a last call to see if you have any questions. And I'll see if the host have any ending statement. Yeah, Shahid, you have so many opportunities. You just have to explore. Okay. Like if you're from a technological technology background, I'm sure you must have got so many. Okay. Especially when it comes to cloud computing, there's so many as far as I know. Okay. The only thing that we have to do is, okay, we have to go ahead and explore the opportunities in the best platform. Okay, gotcha, guys. With this, I am done with the session. And thank you so much for your time. Thank you so much for listening to me. I hope this session will help you in some other way in your career. Bye.